Welcome to the Vector Garden and another video about image trays. In this video, we're going to take a look at these fine white lines that can appear in a trace and also those white issues that you can have here. So there are a lot of holes and you see all these white lines that are in this. Now, it's important to note that I have opened this AI file using the quick look on macOS. So you select a file and then you just press the spacebar and then you get this quick look window, which uses preview, Apple preview. And this uses the PDF that is embedded in an AI file that contains that vector artwork. So in Illustrator, you probably do not see it, but you might see it when opening that PDF, the exported PDF or the embedded PDF in the AI file using a PDF viewer. And you might also see it when you place that AI file into a layout. And you might also see it when you print the file. So this is kind of important that you are able to solve this. Some of that cannot be solved, but some can be solved. So let's take a look at that. I have switched to Illustrator and here is an image. I have placed that image. It's a TIFF image and it's kind of low resolution. So when we zoom in here, then you see the pixels. And tracing this photo for the sake of enlarging it does not make sense in a lot of cases when you might use this technique. It might be better to enlarge the photo, or maybe you do not even need to enlarge the photo because you need very low resolution for banners and posters and the like. Of course, what you should do when you think you need high resolution, talk to the people who will print this and ask them what kind of resolution they really, really need before you try and trace it for the sake of enlarging it. That said, let's take a look at what you do when you do a photorealistic trace. We're going to window image trace and then let's select it and there it is. And then of course we can use one of these presets and maybe we can use that high color preset which does this kind of trace. And we can also start with auto color and see what we get. And Illustrator thinks we want to do an abstract version of that. So here we are, let's enhance that. And let's first set this to more colors. And then also let's set the precision to high and let's set the noise to low, which means that we will get more detail into this. And then we can zoom into this. And you see that is not a very good trace because that image is really low resolution. And I have done that on purpose. And you also can see that we get a lot of these white holes in here. That is something you cannot fully prevent. It's better with higher resolution images, and it also gets better when you trace it with lower precision and when you set the noise slider to a higher value. But then, of course, you don't get as much detail in your trace. So you might need to do it and then you might need to work with the result. Now, if we do this and then save the file and then open that in Acrobat in order to see what we get in the output file, then we will get the gaps. But you see, when we go to view, outline view, then this is not really there. So what is happening here? In here, this is a live object. When I select that, you see it's an image tracing object. You can save that and 3 weeks later you open it and then you adjust the values. That's what a live object does. This live object cannot be saved into the PDF because the PDF file format does not know image trace. So in the PDF, this will be expanded. So let's make a copy of it and then let's expand this. So I'm going to Object, Image Trace, Expand, or what you can also do, of course, is click on this button, which expands it. And then you see there are the Illustrator objects. So when we now go to outline view, then you see, yeah, all these shapes that are neighbored, which is part of that problem. So they are exactly neighbored. So I'm going to save that file. I'm going to save as, and then let's save it into this folder and replace the old one. I'm going to just replace it. And now we're going to take a look at what other applications see here. So I'm going to press the spacebar, and there are those two objects. And then you see this is the left one, which isn't expanded, but in that PDF it is. And the right one is expanded as well. And there we have all those fine lines. That happens because there is anti-aliasing happening, which smooths out all those edges. But since the edges do not overlap, there is some white to be seen because that's the color of the background. So let's see how we can solve that. I'm going to make another copy to here, and let's leave the left one untouched. And for this here, I'm going to check out a different option here down below. Let's select that method like so. And in order to see what this method does, we are going to expand that again. And you see, this already looks different. So when we take a look at this one, then you see there's just one line. And here are two. Let's go into outline view. And you see everywhere are two lines. So Illustrator now makes them overlap. Let's go into preview again. And what you see here, when we zoom in, so they overlap. This one is the top one. And when you move that point, you have to move quite a bit so that there is the white background. Now let's save the file and then let's check it out. Here, there are the three images. And then you see the one in the center, which has this overlap turned on. There are no white lines. Here we have still the white lines, but there we haven't. What stays are the errors, where there's really a lack of precision. And that one can only be saved by cheating. What you can do is go to the rectangle tool and just draw a rectangle in the background. This is now in the foreground, so let's arrange it and send it to the background. And then this kind of hides those. And where it gets lighter coloring, there you have to create a different rectangle in the back that has the same color. Or maybe there are just some places and you can just move the points around. So that is something you need to manually solve.